For decades, under the leadership of Tom Osborne, Nebraska reigned as one of college football's elite programs, winning national titles and dominating the sports landscape. Today, the Huskers reach back to that storied past, looking to regain their national prominence. The Scott Frost era begins on BTN.
And Memorial Stadium in Lincoln is ready for the Scott Frost era to begin. Fans still filing in on a cool, rainy day. And for the first time since he played at Nebraska, Scott Frost leads a Husker team out of the tunnel. The former Husker quarterback with his first Husker team, trying to regain some of those past moments and write a new chapter in the annals of Nebraska history. And the electricity inside this building, obvious today. Even for a practice, Nebraska fans are ready to become relevant again in college football. A sight Nebraska fans have hoped for a long time. Scott Frost leads the Huskers out of the tunnel and in to the 2018 season. Spring football about to close for Nebraska, but a new era opening up. BTN is on hand to chronicle the end of the first spring for Scott Frost and the Huskers as 2018 season beckons ever closer. The red and the white closing out spring today. Hi again, everybody, alongside former Husker running back and current Detroit Lion running back Amir Abdullah. I'm Kevin Kugler, and I know I watched you during that tunnel walk. A little excitement for the former Husker running back and a lot of excitement in this building.
Definitely. The energy in this building today is like none other. I've never seen it like this for a spring game. It's going to be exciting. The fans are looking forward to for the team to turn a new page. Scott Frost is here. Scott Frost era is beginning today.
And the offense changes under Scott Frost. We're going to see a lot of vanilla plays today, but what we are going to see that will resemble the fall is tempo in this offense.
Definitely. They have a very strong receiver core coming back. I know Scott Frost is excited about that. Getting those gadget guys in space, seeing those guys complement that fast-paced offense is going to be exciting today.
No, this is going to be a lot of fun as we get this one started. The red-white game coming up next on BTN. Spring football on BTN is brought to you in part by State Farm, here to help life go right. And by Duluth Trading, tough, ingenious workwear designed and tested by tradesmen. Back in the capital city of Lincoln, Nebraska, the third member of our crew, Damon Benning, moments ago caught up with the head coach, Scott Frost.
You'll see these fans for the first time since your playing days. What did you tell your players about how special this feeling could be and what it should mean to them under your guys' tutelage?
You know, I think the guys know how special the fan base is here. We have this thing sold out for a spring game. It's the first time it's ever happened. But I want them to understand that when they come out and play in front of this group, that we have some pride and we have some things that we need to take care of, being physical, playing the right way. Playing in front of this crowd needs to mean something to them.
All right, before we let you go, Coach, what are you looking for today to let you know that you guys are on the right track?
Hey, we've taken the first few steps on a long journey. I'm looking for some guys to make some plays and hope we get off the field healthy.
All right, welcome back, Coach. Best wishes to you.
Thanks, Amy.
All right, we are ready to get this one started. We're not going to kick it off. We're just going to start from the 20-yard line. The red with Tristan Jebbia at quarterback to start off. Quarterbacks all in green jerseys today. They are not live, so no quarterback is going to the ground unless something wrong happens. As Jebbia on the first play going up top, and the catch for Javon McQuitty. And the first play of the Scott Frost era, a deep toss to the freshman Javon McQuitty.
Yeah, Kevin, talking to Scott Frost yesterday, he really exuded how excited he was about this receiver core, so not surprised.
But it's coming back. Illegal formation against the offense, and so it will walk back five, and the penalty takes away a big play. But it doesn't take away what people expect to see from Javon McQuitty. This is a young wide receiver who was beset with injuries, had a shoulder injury when he came in last January, then missed last year with a knee injury. Coaches really like what he did. They said yesterday to us that he really turned a corner late in this spring.
Definitely. He's been putting in the work, according to the coaches.
And the first carry for Mikhail Wilbon. And Wilbon brought down at the 26-yard line. Will Honus and DeAndre Thomas there on the tackle. First half, standard clock, standard rules, as you would watch in any college football game. Second half, there'll be a running clock, except for the last 5 minutes of the game.
You can see this tempo starting up really early.
Jebbia over the middle finds Mike Williams, another newcomer, and Williams fighting for yardage out to the 32-yard line. Short of the first down by about 2.5 yards, and there's that tempo again that you talk about, Amir, right up to the line, no huddle, look to the sideline for the play call. I think the tempo will be faster when the season hits as well. These guys are still learning, so... As Scott Frost said to Damon, and he told us yesterday, this is just one step.
Of course, when it comes to a lot of more game planning and specifics, they're going to ramp this thing up a lot more.
On third and two, Jebbia will keep, and he shows his wheels. And Jebbia working his way down the sideline. They'll say he was touched up at the 41. It'll be a first down. Well, Damon Benning is with us on the sidelines. And Damon, perhaps an early statement from Tristan Jebbia saying, I know people don't think I can run, but I can run on this play.
Yeah, absolutely. Remember Coach Frost talking yesterday where you don't have to be a 4-3, 4-4 guy, but you do have to be able to make teams play 11-on-11. And you're seeing right away with this tempo, it's the signaling that has been the issue, not really what they want to run. It's making sure that everybody's on the same page. So two things early on that he really spent some time talking to us about yesterday.
Well, that's something we'll keep an eye on throughout this day. Of course, Tristan Jebbia, one of the three quarterbacks that are in the mix, along with Adrian Martinez and Andrew Bunch. Noah Vedral, the fourth quarterback, barring an NCAA waiver, not going to be able to play this season. The transfer from Central Florida as Jack Stoll with the catch at a first down.
It's good to see this white defense swarming right now. Tackling was a big issue for this team last year. See these guys corralling to the ball. It's very encouraging for these coaches, honestly.
Motion out as Jebbia to work. Quick toss to the sideline. Javon McQuitty with the catch, and McQuitty to the 45. One note we should mention as we look at wide receivers, Amir, no Stanley Morgan today. He's been battling this virus that has swept through the team, and no J.D. Spielman either today. Both guys ill and unable to play, so the top two receivers for this squad are not going to be playing in this spring game as Mikhail Wilbon with a nice run up to the 33-yard line.
Yes, talking to Coach Frost, the receiver core is definitely a very deep position for them, not an area of concern. You see Mikhail Wilbon powering through a couple tackles himself.
Wilbon again trying to find some running room, stumbles down at the line of scrimmage. And Damon, when we talk about no Morgan and no Spielman, you get a chance to see some other guys play in this spring game, but this does appear to be a position of strength for Nebraska going into the fall.
Outside of defensive line, probably the one in which they have the most depth. We've seen two guys right away that have had tremendous spring so far. Javon McQuitty, fresh off the ACL injury, but we talked yesterday, remember, he looks electric. Now, he's going against Tony Butler, who's making the switch back from safety to corner, so we'll see how fair that is at the end of the day. But the other guy that they has had rave reviews all summer is Jack Stoll, the guy that they call the best of the bunch. Really, really, really being indicative of what's happened this spring, and that goes right along with Jebbia's accuracy. You won't see the ball hit the ground very much, guys.
Well, it hits the ground there thanks to the play of Jacob Winemaster, a linebacker who's really had a good spring, the junior from Loveland, Colorado. Jebbia under some pressure, and the pressure got to him. Deshaun Neal from that defensive line getting to the quarterback. And boy, that's big news, Amir, because this team did not put a lot of heat on quarterbacks last season at all. For Deshaun Neal to get there early in this, that's a good sign for the Huskers.
Guys like Deshaun Neal, Freedom Akamalodu, those guys have definitely got a lot of talent this year. You know, getting more pressure on the quarterbacks. I know with this new defense, they're going to have a lot more opportunity.
Jebbia going to the air on fourth down. The pass batted away. Eric Lee on the coverage. Mike Williams, the intended receiver, and a flag is down. And that's going to go against the offense.
Five men in the backfield. Hill and his decline. First down.
So the white defense gets the stop on the red offense and turns them over with 10:56 to go in this first quarter. We'll get to see another one of these quarterbacks in the battle for this quarterback job. And it'll be the walk-on Andrew Bunch who makes his way out onto the field. And Andrew Bunch, David Benning, is a guy that's gotten a lot of talk. And Scott Frost has had his eyes opened a little bit by what he's seen from Andrew Bunch in camp.
Yeah, no pun intended, but he may very well have been the best of the bunch. By far the most efficient. And this will be interesting because he doesn't have what I think people would call the top offensive line that he's working with, but he has the best command of the offense. So we'll see if it's a command can take precedent over necessarily what you call talent. He's going against a really, really good defensive bunch. Keep an eye on the two single digits in the middle with Dedrick Young and Muhammad Berry, guys that they have said stood out amongst a very deep crew at inside linebacker.
See Aaron Williams living off the field there.
Bunch with good protection and over the middle, complete at the 46-yard line. Good catch made by one of his veteran receivers, Connor Young, who makes the grab. Andrew Bunch said he's comfortable with the up-tempo. He ran it in high school out of Thompson Station, Tennessee. His dad, David, was a walk-on wide receiver here in the 80s. And a little bit of running room closes quickly. Divino Zigbo trying to find some room.
Stilly.
And he pushes the pile out to the 48-yard line. There are the returning starters on the offensive side for Nebraska. No Cole Conrad. He is out this spring with an injury. Tanner Farmer, Gerald Foster, and Brendan Hymus along that offensive line. Stanley Morgan not playing today. He's been hit by this virus that has seemed to go through this team over the last week. It's had several guys ill over the course of the week.
Returning a lot of guys in the offensive line, I think, will be key. You know, with a lot of these young quarterbacks, they need a lot of protection to, you know, go through their reads quickly. That's going to be really important.
There's David Engelhop. Another one of those tight ends in a tight end battle that's Damon Benning is going to be a very interesting position because Scott Frost used the tight ends an awful lot last year at Central Florida. 55 catches, almost 900 yards at the position.
Right, and versatility is going to be the key, right? Because they can use them as an inline tight end in a traditional role, or you can flex out and play the hybrid. The way that he utilizes them makes it really hard to match up if you're a personnel grouping guy. You'll see two guys that look like tight ends enter the huddle, and you maybe think big package as a defensive coordinator, yet you'll see them line up in the slot and be a part of RPO. So just part of the headache and the confusion that the tempo can add, that's that tight end position.
On third down and two at the 45. Ozigbo again bouncing off the Muhammad Berry tackle, and Ozigbo powers his way for the first down. And Amir, you and I were talking before the game. You're a big Divine Ozigbo fan.
I'm a real big Divine Ozigbo fan. I think he's finally understanding that he's a big back. He's a guy who can run behind his pads and really be effective between the tackles. He's transformed his body this offseason, got his lower body a lot stronger. So I look to see Nebraska using him in a lot of those tight quarter situations.
This I-back battle, if you can still call it an I-back after all these years in Nebraska, this I-back battle is going to be a very interesting one going into the fall. Another carry for Ozigbo, and he powers his way to the 35. And David Benning, we've not even seen yet Jalen Bradley and or Greg Bell in front of this big crowd. But Greg Bell's certainly a guy that I-back spot figures to have a role for this year.
You ask my opinion, I think he's the most dynamic of the bunch. He's got a little Le'Veon Bell to his game where he can lazy leg you, he can dead foot you, he can change planes. He's got a different gear, but the competition will reign supreme because I think the biggest deal will be your versatility. You have to be able to do multiple things in this offense. As we take a look at Bunch with a great read, right? He sees the 3-on-2 out here and goes to the wide guy. It's one of those deals, Kevin and Amir, where I just got the sense all spring that his command would supersede the talent level because he knows more than everybody else, and he's very comfortable doing it. And this is what a lot of people would call the top unit, or closer to the top unit defensively, that he's chopping up right now.
Todd Honus, the wide receiver who made that catch at the 23-yard line on first down. Here's Jalen Bradley with a flag down, and Bradley down near the 16-yard line.
Bradley's definitely a wild card. He's a guy who can make a lot of people miss in space. He has some suddenness to him. I just really want to see him hit the hold a lot quicker. He has quick feet, but sometimes he's a little hesitant, and then, you know, that's not what you want to see in backs when you get into Big Ten play.
Does that come from experience? How do you get that ability to hit that hole quicker?
Just confidence. Film study, understanding what's going on before it may happen.
So Jalen Bradley, whose top choices out of high school were Nebraska and Central Florida, he loves this offense. He said it's nearly identical in a lot of ways to what he ran as an offense at Bellevue West High School. So he should feel very comfortable in this offense. Bunch has Bradley to his right and Honus to his left. And a timeout's going to be used by the white offense. 7:01 remaining in the first quarter. Now Scott Frost in his first spring game back as head coach. Of course, his mentor, longtime head coach Tom Osborne. And just a few moments ago, Damon had the chance to catch up with not only Scott's former head coach, but his former head coach, Tom Osborne.
Coach, in what may be a chapter in Nebraska football history that's kind of fairy tale-ish, this one is real. You're back involved, Scott Frost now the new head coach, and it's good to see you around the program again. How do you feel? What's it been like for you?
Well, it's great to see Scott back, and obviously he knows what buttons to push. So I think things will get much better. And I wasn't away from the program. I just had other things to do. I'd down to practice once in a while under Mike Riley, but I try to come down a little more often now. But he's got a good staff, a lot of energy, young guys, and I think they're doing a good job recruiting, which is important too.
You usually have really good discernment. It seems like you've got a good vibe on the direction that they're moving. What is it that you've seen so far that's allowed you to kind of be comfortable with the transition?
Well, I think the chemistry is better. I think the players need to enjoy what they're doing, and I think they're doing that. I think there's a little bit more accountability. I think the strength program has obviously shifted, and that's kind of where it has to start. We need to get stronger, and I think we are. And so I think a lot of things are moving in the right direction, but it's not going to be automatic. It's not going to be necessarily quick and easy. And sometimes people see that turnaround at Central Florida and think, well, in 2 years we'll be undefeated. And that was a miracle. I mean, that just doesn't happen. But I think it's going to get better.
Coach, always good to see you.
Okay, thanks, David.
Always good to see Coach Osborne. First down and 5. For the white offense. Nice catch on a tough pitch from Jalen Bradley, but good swarm from that red defense. Williams, Young, Berry all in on the tackle. Scott Frost probably won't smile that broadly when plays don't go that way in the fall.
Well, that's the second time you've seen the option implemented on this drive, so I'm expecting that to be definitely a go-to when they check into blitzes or anything like that heading forward.
Second down. 10 yards to go for the first. That's Bradley in motion. And Bradley with a carry. And Berry with the tackle at the 20-yard line. Ben Stille there as well to make the stop. So we've seen Divine Ozigbo. We've seen Jalen Bradley at the running back spot. Mikhail Wilbon for the red squad. This running back position certainly has room for improvement. The longest run by a running back a year ago for Nebraska was 35 yards. They had 41 catches as a unit. And over the last 3 years, they've only had 16 rushing plays, 30 yards or more. To the end zone. Caught. Touchdown, Brian Reimers.
Excellent delivery. Excellent delivery by Bunch.
There is a flag down as the balloons go up. It's an illegal shift.
Offense, number 43, moving forward at the snap. 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
It's Damon's job now to go get all of these balloons that everybody let off for the touchdown, because it's not a touchdown. The illegal shift brings it back. But an excellent touch regardless from Bunch to Reimers, Damon.
He's for real, and I think everybody that is watching this first drive happen that wondered if it was just a spring feel-good story now understands clearly he's talented, and he does have the good command, but how about the accuracy? That's the only place that Reimers could have got it, and he put it where it needed to be. He'll get another crack at it. Don't think he's done yet here on this drive, fellas.
So back it up. Try to retract those balloons. Third and 11. Bunch to the air again. Looking to the other side. A jump ball for Kirk Rapdahl, but he's out of bounds. That's another interesting playmaker, though, at tight end, the redshirt freshman from Indiana. And Rapdahl, did he get the foot in? Oh, it looks like he did.
He did.
And it's a touchdown.
I like how Bunch looks off the safety. Just that little glance that he gave the separation he needed to complete this play. Wow.
Since it's a spring game, the officials didn't need to go under the hood to check out the replay review. They just looked on the big screens and called it a touchdown. So a 24-yard touchdown to Kirk Rapdahl and Cole Fromm on, the freshman from Omaha Burke High School, for the extra point. And Fromm, in a kicking battle, misses the extra point. So an early edge perhaps for Barrett Pickering. And Andrew Bunch, what a drive for this sophomore walk-on, Damon Benning, as he marches the Husker White squad down the field and into the end zone for six.
Yeah, the savvy, he oozes it. But I think it's the accuracy that caught the coaching staff off guard, right? Because you see a guy that you think's a good athlete, he tells you he's, you know, accustomed to running this hurry-up offense, and then you watch him spin it, and you're thinking that you're really on to something. Again, the ball to Rapdahl, who is highly touted coming out of high school. He was a coveted tight end. The only place that he could get it is where Bunch delivers it. You'll see a lot of that today from that combo.
So the white squad with the 6-0 lead, and the red team back to work at the 25-yard line. So Bunch does his job at quarterback, and now for the first time we get to see true freshman Martinez touched up as he gets close to the line of scrimmage. Quayshon Alexander on the tackle. And Adrian Martinez, Amir, he is the guy that Scott Frost went after when he found out he was going to become, when he took the job as Husker head coach. This was his chosen quarterback, the true freshman out of Fresno, California. Missed his senior year with a shoulder injury, but this is the guy that Scott Frost looked at and said, that's the guy who can lead this team into the future. As Tyshawn Lindsey with some running room. Lindsey down inside midfield at the 47-yard line.
This is a guy that has the entire coaching staff offensively and defensively excited. He reminds me a lot of Jamal Turner when I played. Very shifty, quick as a cat, light on his feet, gadget kind of guy.
Quick toss to Jack Stoll at the tight end. Gains positive yardage down to the 43-yard line. Avery Anderson in there on the tackle for the white squad. This offensive line on the red team, you've got Brendan Hymus at left tackle, Gerald Foster at the left guard, Hunter Miller the center today, and then your right guard, Tanner Farmer, with the right tackle, Matt Farniak. Martinez, does he get touched up? Not yet, and Martinez now touched near the 40-yard line. How hard is it, Amir, to give yourself an ability to grade quarterbacks fully when they're not live and touch football becomes the order of the day?
It's really tough. So something that I look for, though, is pocket presence and the quarterback's feet in the pocket, how quickly he can step up, how shifty he is with his jump cut and such like that. And with the offense that you run a lot of zone read, you don't get a true look.
Defense, number 34, 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
That's Breon Dixon, who with the offside. All right, Verduzco, the quarterback coach for the Huskers. Quizzing the guys on the playbook. That's coming up in the next couple of weeks. And that's how he grades them. Grades them on leadership, grades them on the playbook and their knowledge of it, with quizzes to come. These guys all have a big test after today coming up, as that catch made by Mike Williams and out of bounds close to the first down yardage at the 28-yard line. So far, so good for Coach Verduzco's young pupil, Adrian Martinez. The freshman who injured that shoulder, then went ahead and played basketball with the injured shoulder before he knew just how serious it was. And the little sprint out to Stoll. Got a block, and Stoll turns it upfield to the 21-yard line. Credit Mike Williams for the block on the edge, and Stoll gets the first down.
Stoll has definitely become a reliable piece for this offense. Back in the days we used to play, we had guys like Kyler Reed, Ben Cotton, who were reliable targets down the middle. I see him having another productive year this year.
Well, that blocking from wide receivers, that's something that Troy Walters, the offensive coordinator, wide receiver coach, really stresses. They keep a chart of blocking points in the wide receiver room. First carry for Greg Bell. And Bell with a stop and start out to the 15-yard line.
There's that suddenness that Damon spoke about earlier. Quick gear, kind of hesitant, just like Le'Veon Bell. Jumped to the side, saw the hole, hit it fast.
That's a pretty heavy comparison to have with Le'Veon Bell if you're Greg Bell, because I don't know there's anybody in football that does a better job, no offense to you, in the stop and start than Le'Veon Bell.
Le'Veon Bell is incredible. Definitely.
Martinez showing his running ability, and Martinez into the end zone. Was he touched? He's celebrating. He is in for the touchdown.
That might have given the fans a little reminder of another Martinez that played a couple years ago. Taylor Martinez accelerating. He has some wheels, and this is what Scott Frost is looking for in this offense. A guy who can definitely pick the defense apart with his accuracy, but also with his feet as well.
Pretty good start for a couple of new quarterbacks on this Nebraska roster, as Adrian Martinez, the true freshman, moves him right down the field, and the extra point up and good. And the Red Squad takes a 7-6 lead on the strength of the Barrett Pickering extra point. 2:21 to go in the first. And Damon Benning, these quarterbacks have all had good things to talk about in their first series. Tristan Jebby is starting it off, but now the touchdown drives from Bunch and Martinez.
Right. Anything you can do, I can do better, right? Really showcasing their talents. And you kind of see what everybody does a little bit different. Martinez, the most natural of the runners. Jebby, the best pure passer. Bunch, maybe the combo of the two. So I think, you know, Coach Frost said he's going to wait at least until fall camp to name a starter. You see why, because you can see flashes of everything that you could take, but you want the one that's the most complete, and that's going to come over time. So this is going to be a heck of a quarterback battle to watch.
And back out at that quarterback position now is Andrew Bunch, the first quarterback. Nope, it is not Andrew Bunch. Bunch is out there, but he stands to the right and goes in motion. Vedrill, the quarterback. And Noah Vedrill with the toss to Jalen Bradley. That play well defended, and the tackle by Peyton Newell.
Great recognition by Peyton Newell. That's a guy who's been working day in and day out in this program, going into his fifth year. Had to sit behind a couple DNs. Now he's made the transition inside. Great recognition on his part.
So Noah Vedrill, back for his home state team, transferred in this year from Central Florida following Scott Frost. He played in 8 games at Central Florida a year ago at a Bishop Newman High School in Wahoo. Vedrill touched up, and that's a sack. The pressure from Alex Davis. And let's check in once more with Damon Benning.
Guys, one of the legends, right? Arguably one of the greatest defensive players to play at the university. Defined the weak side linebacker position, Terrell Farley. Terrell, welcome back, first of all. Man, how do you feel seeing 90,000 for practice? Does it bring back memories?
Yeah, it does, man. It feels really great, and just to see our community come together and everybody rallying for Scott Frost, and to see new things happen at Nebraska.
Did you ever think that you'd see a former teammate come back to be a head coach at the university?
I thought they would probably go after one of the marquee, higher name, older coaches, but I'm glad it's Scott. I'd rather have Scott here than anybody else.
You heard it here. That's one of the guys that could unify the bunch. That's Coach Frost. That's Terrell Farley.
Well, and if you're a younger fan and you don't know who Terrell Farley was when he played, YouTube is a wonderful resource. Look it up. There are few players who have ever worn the uniform in Nebraska history that played that position better than Terrell Farley. White squad going to punt it away. Isaac Armstrong, the punter. Tyjon Lindsey back deep. And Lindsey will let this one roll. End up being a good punt for Armstrong out of bounds at the 32-yard line. Terrell Farley, as disruptive a force as ever played on that black shirt defense. First down for the Red with 16 seconds remaining in this first quarter. A packed house today. People think that's somehow photoshopped. It's not. I mean,
these people, they love their football here. Rain, sleet, or snow, they're going to be out here spring game or regular game every Saturday.
First to Jebbia, back to work at quarterback. A little bobble of the snap, able to make something out of it as he runs into the arms of Eric Lee. Should be the final play of this opening quarter. The red-white game. First appearance for Scott Frost as Husker head coach. And at the end of one quarter, Nebraska's red squad leading Nebraska's white squad 7-6. What a day in Lincoln. Plenty more to come on BTN. This was planned. I mean, we wanted to have Amir wave to the crowd. Now they're honoring a lot of the current Huskers playing in the National Football League. Amir last on the list, but certainly not last in the hearts of Husker fans up here in the booth with me. So got the chance to get a nice ovation from a big crowd one more time at Memorial Stadium. And plenty to cheer about with the terrific career of Amir Abdullah. And every time I watch these highlights, and we watch these before the game too, Amir, I think you were really good in the offense that you were running in then. I got to imagine you'd really enjoy this offense that Scott Frost is trying to install at Nebraska.
Man, if I could just get one year just to play with this guy right here. But no, he's instilling a great offense. I think a lot of these backs are going to complement it well.
Red squad going back to work as we start this second quarter. Jebbia over the middle finds another tight end. That's Austin Allen, the freshman from Aurora, Nebraska. We don't know who's going to win this running back battle at Nebraska, but if they can put up numbers like Amir did in his career, I think everybody who cheers for the Huskers would be very happy with numbers like that out of that I-back spot. Javon McQuitty out to the 49. Markel Dismuke makes the stop.
Flattered, Kevin. Flattered. Thank you.
Give over the left side. Nice cut and good yardage for Wyatt Mazur. And Mazur gets the first down.
Definitely. Great open field move. I think the zone read offense they're putting in is definitely going to be a big advantage for Nebraska heading forward. A lot of misdirection. You see a lot of quick play fake, get the ball in their hands. Sometimes they hand it, sometimes they don't. That run-pass option is going to be a huge advantage for them at moving forward.
Tempo really rolling. Today on BTN, the Nittany Lions take the field in Happy Valley for their blue-white game. Don't miss live coverage of Penn State spring football today, 3 Eastern, right here on BTN, streaming live on BTN to go and Fox Sports Go. On 2nd and 4, Jebbia to Lindsey.
There it is again.
And Lindsey to the sideline, close to the first down.
You see a lot of motioning in this offense. That's going to make them have to be a lot more precise. A lot of guys got to line up quick with that tempo, being that they're doing a lot of motioning. But it's going to be effective if they can get it down.
Zur and Lindsey in the backfield. Lindsey in motion. Jebbia waiting, had Allen open, just couldn't hit Austin Allen. Waited for him to get clear, and he did, just missed him along the sideline.
There's that one pass option again. You see Lindsey going in motion, fake it to him, had the wheel route, just couldn't execute.
So 2nd down and 10 for the Red at the white 34. Sevilla. Incomplete off the hands of Justin McGriff, the true freshman who came in, was a UCF guy, and then committed to Nebraska late in the process. He's at 6'6", 220 right now. The coaches have said if he gained more weight, he might eventually be a tight end in this offense, but right now he's running with the wide receivers.
Well, you see him run. You wouldn't think he's 6'6". He gets in and out of his breaks like a 5'9 guy, so that's encouraging. Now, I'm pretty sure he can either stay or receive
offside. Defense, number 18, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Third down and five. Jebbia will look to the sidelines now. And on third down, the pitch to Mazur. Good defense. And there's Will Honus, who makes the tackle. David, let's talk linebackers a little bit, because Will Honus is a name that we not only heard a lot in the recruiting process, but heard a lot from coaches when we talked with them yesterday. Will Honus figures into that inside linebacker rotation pretty early, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. He's a guy that you roll the tape, you watch him at the junior college level. He was the classic runner hitter, right? And the coaches, what they wanted to see today was him really turn it loose. See, there was a little bit of that paralysis by analysis, because when he gets to where he's going, it's usually with bad intentions. And you saw him flash right there. He's playing along some guys that are in that same vein, right? With Deshaun Neal, who they like, who said has shown flashes. They think the light switch may have come on. And in the transfer from Ole Miss, that they're still awaiting the ruling on Breon Dixon, who they just brought on the blitz. Guys that need to step up and develop in the program to help continue to add defensive depth. Because as we heard yesterday, they're a little bit behind on that side of the ball in terms of scholarship distribution.
Yeah, the defensive line is the strength of that defense. Mike Dawson, the defensive line coach, says it's as deep as he's been coaching at any position since he's been coaching. They need some help behind that defensive line as Divino Zigbo carrying the football across the 40-yard line. We've seen some good work from the senior Divino Zigbo. Carlos Davis out there on the stop.
Zigbo has a deceptive step to him. He's a big guy, so I don't think he can really run that fast. But when he gets moving, he's really humming.
Zigbo again on the handoff from Bunch, and he's got the first down to the 41. Peyton Newell in there on the stop. That defensive line, Newell running in the middle of that 3-4 defensive line right now, Amir. Mick Stoltenberg is out for the spring, and Stoltenberg figures to be the guy who opens it up on September 1st as the nose tackle.
Yes, you want a guy like Stoltenberg in the middle. Big guy who's going to not be moved easily.
On first down, Bunch to the air, and the catch made by Ozigbo. Good open field tackle by Dedrick Young. How would you assess the tackling early in this? Because as you mentioned earlier, Amir, tackling was a huge problem for Nebraska last year.
I'm impressed. You know, I've seen a lot of impressive open field tackles, and if they do miss one,
Steve, I got another really good guy, former.
Second down and eight at the 43. Just as the rush gets there, Bunch gets rid of it. And the pass incomplete brings up third down.
Tackling definitely is an area that is a point of emphasis for Nebraska this year. A lot of missed tackles last year that led to bigger plays than they needed. So gang tackling is definitely the MO for this team.
Talking with defensive coordinator Eric Chenander yesterday, and he said, we went live more in this spring than any spring that I can remember with Coach Frost at any point. He said, we want to see who can play when the lights go on, but we went live more to work on some of those areas, like tackling.
You're a creature of habit, so the more you do things, the better off you want to be.
On third down and eight, Bunch in some trouble. He eludes the rush, throws on the run. Nice catch by Ozigbo, and Divine Ozigbo with a first down. Bunch bought time, Ozigbo with the pluck. And Damon Benning, good work all the way around, quarterback and running back.
Yeah, see, that's what you get with him, right? With that the art of the improv of him knowing where everybody is on the football field. He's got good poise in the pocket, and then he's able to know where his outlets and dump downs are. And then you get a chance to see Amir's guy, Divine Ozigbo, being a little multifaceted catching the football.
Maybe Divino Zigbo got a bad rap like Amir Abdullah did when everybody said, oh, Amir didn't catch the ball much at Nebraska, so we're not going to throw to him as often as we should in the National Football League.
Oh,
this
man.
Is your chance to say right now, throw me the ball more. Let's go, Matthew Stafford.
You said it, not me. You said it, not me.
Here's Bradley. Looking for a little room, and Bradley down to the 30-yard line. David Benning standing by with the Husker National Champion, Tony Veland.
Yeah, Husker National Champion Tony Veland is right. One of my very best friends. Tony getting a chance to come back and see what's going on. By the former teammate and coach Frost, and the vibe is just a little bit different now, isn't it?
It's just a little bit different. There's a lot more excitement, which is good. This place is filled, which is awesome. I'm seeing some things on offense that we haven't seen generally in most spring games because it's generally kind of blah. So I'm pretty excited. It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun.
You had a lot of versatility as a player. You came as a quarterback. You went to the NFL as a free safety. Coach Frost and his staff has talked a lot about getting top-notch athletes that are able to do multiple things. Do you like the way that the game is changing in terms of almost the positionless player?
I do like that. I do like that. Honestly, I feel like that's what made us a very strong team, because you brought players out there who made plays, and if they didn't make plays at their position, you put them at a different position and they still made plays. So if they can get those types of players here and get the leadership going, I think we've got a good chance to be good.
Guys, one of the best in the business in a class act, my man Tony Veland.
All right, David, thanks very much. Saw a nice run there from Jalen Bradley, where it looked like he did what you were asking him to do a little bit earlier, Amir, and that's get to the hole and then explode through it.
Very decisive, but Muhammad Barry exploded through him right after he got upfield. So good play offensively and defensively there.
Bradley down to the 9-yard line as this white squad tries to grab the lead here. Trailing 7-6. 9 minutes remaining in the first half.
Just seeing Bunch conduct these drives is really encouraging. He plays with so much poise and confidence. I know these coaches are loving seeing what he's doing right now.
Ball popped out, but they're going to rule him down. Good penetration by Peyton Newell, and then Colin Miller, who's had a really consistent spring. That was one of the guys that Eric Chenander brought up yesterday, and we were talking about these linebackers with him, and he said, you know, Tyron Ferguson, very consistent at linebacker. Colin Miller as well, another one who's had a really good spring at that linebacker spot.
Yeah, the linebacker spot may be the position group that has the most to prove on this defense. These guys are supposed to be the leaders, the guys hitting the, you know, the tackling bunch. They want to see a big spike in improvement in that group this year, and having guys like that making plays out here today is definitely going to be encouraging for these coaches.
Third and 8 from the 12. Bunch on the roll. Bunch tried to throw it back across his body, looking for Kurt Raftall as he got to the sideline, but Rita Mackin-Maladun was hot on his heels, and either it was Akinmaladun or the sideline, but he had to get rid of it somehow, and the field goal unit on. And on comes Cole Fromm, who missed an extra point earlier. The freshman out of Omaha Burke, whose cousin kicked at Nebraska, Dale Klein, one of the all-time greats from a Nebraska kicking standpoint, still holds the NCAA record with 7 field goals in one game. That's Dale Klein. Cole Fromm looking for his first in a Husker uniform, this in the spring game. Able to put that one through and give the white squad the lead, 9-7. The 30-yard field goal makes it a 9-7 advantage for the white. 8:01 remaining in this first half, and my goodness, what a day in Lincoln, Nebraska. The State Farm State of Success, and a crowd today that puts Nebraska in the top 10 all time across college football, 86,818. On hand here today for the spring game. This thing sold out, Amir, in a day and a half. A little bit of excitement coming off a 4-8 season for Scott Frost to return, and 86,818 piling in to watch a practice. And this isn't even, as in springs past, the last practice, because Scott Frost and his team are going to be back out on the field on Monday to cap spring with one more practice. He said we were just initially going to give him some instructions as to what we wanted him to do in the summer. He says it was yesterday. Now we're going out for a full practice.
Yeah, just seeing the energy that Scott Frost is bringing to the stadium is refreshing for our alumni. I'm sure for all the fans here today, it's special to see.
Well, certainly Nebraska fans remember the end of the career of Scott Frost very fondly when the Huskers won a national championship for Tom Osborne in his final year. But Scott Frost transferred back home from Stanford. Sat out in 1995 and 96. An up and down year for the Huskers. They cap at the Orange Bowl where Damon Benning was the Orange Bowl MVP. And then 1997, they go out. And really the season turns at Washington for Scott Frost and company. They move on through there. Of course, the scare at Missouri, the miracle at Missouri on the deflected kick into the arms of the freshman at the time, Matt Davison. And Scott Frost and the Huskers win the national title that year, a share of it with Michigan. And there are the two that combined on that catch. Matt Davison working the sidelines and now the associate athletic director for football. And Scott Frost, the head coach. Pretty impressive numbers.
Scott looks like he can still play. He does, man.
We saw some footage last year while they were getting ready to close the season at Central Florida of Scott running the option in practice. And you're right, Amir. He looked like he could still go as Mikhail Wilbon with the carry out to the 30-yard line.
I think Wilbon's going to be a guy who provides a lot of consistency to this offense. He's going to be a running back by committee type of team. He's going to be a guy who's going to be asked to, you know, fill some heavy shoes every now and then.
Here's Martinez in some trouble. And good penetration from Finn Anderson brings Martinez down back to the 25. And, Damon, we talked a little bit about this I-back spot. You've got Greg Bell. You've got Mikhail Wilbon. You've got Divine Ozigbo. You've got Jalen Bradley. One name we've not mentioned is the name of Trey Bryant. He was injured early last year after a really good start to the season. He's still trying to get back. Does he fit in to this mix in the fall?
Well, I think, you know, we heard Coach Frost tell us when healthy and you watch the film, one of the few guys they went back and wanted to study, right? Because they really didn't want any preconceived notion, but Trey Bryant was a guy that a lot of people had respect for. They said, let me go back and watch this guy. Really impressed. Even said things like when he was healthy, he was one of the best out there. So this process that he's going through now with is almost like kind of an arthritic knee has been tough to watch unfold. He started a little bit of the straight line running a couple of weeks ago as he's continuing to try to build up speed. I'm cautiously optimistic, but I think he's still a ways away from being to contribute just based on seeing him up close these last 3 or 4 weeks.
All right, Damon, thanks very much. Tyjon Lindsey on the sideline with the catch. Tackle made by Spencer Jordan at the 40-yard line, but that's a first down, and Lindsey showing up again. He had Oregon on his list coming out of high school, Amir, and then Scott Frost left Oregon, so he kind of backed away from that. But one of his mentors is former Oregon Duck and current Kansas City Chief DeAnthony Thomas. And he'd certainly love to duplicate some of the stuff we've seen DeAnthony Thomas do on the football field.
I definitely like the way they've used Tyjon Lindsey today, moving around a lot of space. I see Mikhail Wilbon, the great run there. But Tyjon Lindsey is going to be a huge piece for this offense moving forward. The things he can do playing outside, inside, even at running back at times, he's going to be very effective for this offense.
Well, of course, again, no Stanley Morgan today, no J.D. Spielman today. So the top two receivers from a year ago who figured a factor large in this offense in the fall, not out there today as Wilbon tries the sweep to the outside. Didn't have a lot of running room, and Breon Dixon there to close the door very quickly along with Guy Thomas.
There you see again, though, this defense is swarming around. They're playing with a lot more confidence, and the speed of the defense is something that these coaches on the defense side of the ball have been emphasizing. Getting to the ball with a sense of urgency. First guy made contact, and the Cowboys coming next.
Martinez with pressure up the middle from Honus, and Martinez will duck out of bounds at the 42, David.
Getting a really good look at Coach Rude watching from the white sidelines, watching these linebackers play. And you heard Coach Chenander say yesterday about this linebacking core under Coach Rude's tutelage. He doesn't want them tentative, coming to balance, chopping your feet on the tackle. When you miss, miss to your leverage, let the rest of the dogs go hunt. And you've kind of seen that on this series, especially between guys like Honus, Winemaster, and Breon Dixon. And as I say that, they get gashed up the middle, but that's the good eye deception from Martinez holding Winemaster in play. That's good eye manipulation. But back to the downhill kind of style of these linebackers, they want to see more of that because, again, like you said earlier, Kevin, they like the depth of their D-line. If that second level can be a little bit more decisive, they think they may be able to protect the lack of depth in the secondary, at least for this upcoming year.
Tackled by Will Honus from that linebacking core with the touch on Martinez to the edge. That run before from Greg Bell, who showed that burst right up the middle. to get the first down. Martinez off play action wants the screen for Bell and couldn't quite get it to him. Looked like it was set up too with three blockers out front.
I'm really excited to see this spread attack ops offense re-implemented here in Nebraska, because that's what I played a little bit here with Taylor Martinez and a couple other guys, Tommy Armstrong as well, and it was really effective. You know, it just gives you so much diversity. You don't know if the quarterback's going to have it, running back's going to have it, and what I'm seeing from these backs and quarterbacks today is definitely a good sign.
Bell motion out. Martinez, good protection, throws it wide open. Touchdown, Javon McQuitty. 25 yards from Martinez to McQuitty. And the Red back on top.
Excellent job by Martinez there. Selling the fake, keeping his eyes downfield, delivering. There's McQuitty again, as you spoke upon earlier.
Well, Damon Benning, Adrian Martinez, the true freshman, has looked pretty sharp in the early going here for this Red squad at quarterback.
Yeah, he's been unbelievable in terms of kind of being able to weather maybe a little mistake and recouping and resetting to the next play. I think that's one of the things that the coaches are encouraged by. You watched his poise in the pocket right there. That was right after the ill-advised pass on the screen play. So the short memory at the quarterback spot is a really good thing. And it's always nice to see a guy like Javon McQuitty really start to flourish, because I think last year, had he been healthy in camp, he would have challenged to play as a freshman. He's coming off the ACL injury this year. He has worked his tail off. And like Coach Frost told us yesterday, you can tell football is important to him.
He turned that corner late in the spring where it really seemed to start clicking for that freshman out of Columbia, Missouri. Huskers are really high on him, and that wide receiver core, you see some of the depth on display here today. That's a position of strength for Nebraska going into the fall.
And their lead guy, as we mentioned earlier, Stan Morgan, he's not even playing today, so.
J.D. Spielman, the second leading receiver, out as well, as Noah Vedral back in at quarterback, and they're going to throw. Honus got hit as he threw, and it's going to be intercepted by Lamar Jackson. Jackson, who does not have an interception in his career, comes up with a pick in the spring game at the 41-yard line.
He's a guy I'm waiting to take charge. He's a physical. Here's the replay here. You can see the trick play unsuccessful. But Lamar Jackson is a guy who has all the physical measurables, tall corner, long arms. The NFL loves guys like him. I'm waiting for him to take charge and really just own what he's been blessed with.
Eric Chenander doing a little bit of congratulation and a little bit of coaching there as well. They know, they look at that, they see a guy who's 6'3", 210, and they know that's somebody who could be a real big help to them in the secondary.
Certainly.
Tristan Jebbia back out there, quarterback now for the Red. And Jebbia going up top, looking for Mike Williams. And the pass incomplete, but a flag. Coverage from Tony Butler. And Jebbia, after the turnover on quick change, going deep.
I'd like to see Jebbia put just a little bit more on that ball. He has a receiver there. The pass interference shouldn't even been in play there. Should put just a little bit on it.
Pass interference, defense, number two, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
So a first down after the penalty. Jebbia and the offense will move up 15. Well, we're closing in on halftime, 4:37 remaining in this first half. Coming up at half, Bill Moose, the athletic director of the Huskers, going to join me upstairs here in the broadcast booth. Plus, we'll give you a preview of what's coming up afterwards in the Big Ten Spring Football Report. Jerry DiNardo had the chance to sit down a few days ago with the head coach of the Huskers for a nice long conversation. We'll give you a preview of what Coach DiNardo and Coach Frost talked about coming up at halftime. Down to the 23-yard line goes Greg Bell. Bell is 6'2", 200 pounds, transferred in from Arizona Western Community College. He's the first junior college running back in Nebraska since Kenny Wilson back in 2006. And Wilson never really was able to get on track. He injured his leg moving a television and was never able to really find his footing after that. Greg Bell, the first junior college running back since that time to come into Lincoln. Problem with a handoff. Bell able to secure it, and Bell able to work his way for the first down to the 10-yard line. Tell me about that from a running back standpoint. quarterback and running back jostling for the ball, and it ends up on the hip of the running back here.
It's just repetition. In practice, you get a lot of situations where it may not be the cleanest mesh, but you got to make it happen. To see Jeffia here, I don't know if they're going to give him a touchdown. They're going to mark him down at the 3-yard line. But it's just repetition. You can understand that these guys go through countless hours of quarterback, running back exchanges. Being in the spread offense is really important. But Greg Bell has really showed a lot today. I like his hips. Very, very shifty for his size.
Here's Bell again. This time ran into trouble in the backfield. There's Jacob Winemaster. Part of a football family, Kerry Winemaster, former Husker nose guard back in the 70s, an all-Big 8 player. Jacob Winemaster, the junior out of Loveland, and a lot of raves from the coaching staff about his performance this spring, and now movement up front. We've seen a lot of movement early on that defensive line. Breon Dixon's been kind of anxious.
Defense for 34, half the distance to the goal, third down.
Trying to get a jump on that tempo that this offense plays at. Damian Daniels, who's in the middle of that defensive line, still just a youngster at 18 years old, but he said he's lost a lot of weight. He said the tempo of this offense really helps me with my conditioning. I'm not putting it back on running against these guys. Jebbia trying to punch this one in to the air. Touchdown.
So far, we've seen all these quarterbacks that should make great drives.
It has been a very solid performance across the board for all these quarterbacks. Good throw from Jebbia here, Amir.
That's what he does well. He's a much better intermediate passer than he is with the deep ball. But in this style of offense, that's what these quarterbacks are going to be called upon to do more often than to throw the deep ball.
Extra point try for the freshman scholarship kicker, Barrett Pickering, is up, and it is good. And David Benning, I mentioned Damian Daniels' comments about how the tempo of the offense has helped his conditioning, but conditioning and strength has really been an emphasis of Zach Duvall. Not only he's the strength and conditioning coach, not only through the winter, but throughout the spring.
Yeah, it's the prevailing theme, isn't it? Outside of kind of the unity and familyness together, it has been strength and conditioning. I think it's an interesting concept that they're employing. We've seen both on the offensive side and the defensive side. They went full concept through the whole kitchen sink at the guys, and we'll worry about game day adjustments later. Thought the physical part of it would catch up over the summer. They were very confident not to scale back any concepts offensively or defensively. And having said that, they're trusting full well, as Coach Frost told us, the most important guy on his staff is Zach Duvall, that he'll take care of them in the summer where guys can understand what it means to run all day and to be able to play 90 to 100 snaps. It's going to be quite the learning process.
Well, and David, I know you're on the sidelines, so you don't have a monitor, but as you were talking, we were looking at Zach Duvall on the sidelines, and I don't know about you, David, or Amir, but I look at Zach Duvall, I'm not going to question anything that guy says.
Yeah, I tell you, the first time I talked to him, I stopped down in the weight room, and he had on black cowboy boots and a black button-down shirt, and he was a little revved on high, so I talked quickly, as I didn't want to catch any parts of the heels of those boots.
Good play by Ben Stille along the defensive line, moving to the end position this year. And that's another guy that Chenander talked at length about yesterday as far as Ben Stille was concerned. Damon, he thinks he's a guy with a future, his hand on the ground.
Yeah, that was a great conversation, wasn't it? Because I think coming out of high school, we had the discussions in the media and even with the former staff. You know, how did you decide between two-point and three-point? And Coach Frost and Coach Chenander said, listen, as he did what we wanted him to do in terms of the weight room, we knew that he was going to be a guy that was going to grow, and we were going to let God do the rest. And when he said that, he said, listen, your hand in the dirt is going to give you the best chance to have success. And they're pretty excited about him as well.
Alex Davis with the interception here is Vedral off the back foot trying to get it out to Austin Rose, and Alex Davis with the pick. So the defense comes up with an interception, and that's an area, Amir, that Nebraska would really love to improve upon, the takeaway department. They had 12 takeaways last year, 9 interceptions as a team. Central Florida had 32 takeaways, 20 interceptions last year in their undefeated season.
Yes, talking to Coach Frost yesterday, he said the number one thing he looks at when he's evaluating the quarterback is taking care of the football. And Vezra right there is definitely not going to make him happy saying that.
Tyshawn Lindsey trying to reverse his field, and Lindsey getting positive yardage.
I tell you, man, that guy, he's really light on his feet, quick as a cat, man. He reminds me a lot of Jamal Turner, man. This guy, I think, is definitely going to be instrumental to a lot of big wins for Nebraska this year.
Jamal Turner was one of those guys that you always saw what he could do, but it was never able to happen in games. You had the opportunity to see him in practices more often than not, and I know he was a guy that took your breath away in practice.
He's a guy I learned a lot from. You know, in practice, he would do things that just took your breath away. So
here's Martinez, wide open into the end zone for the touchdown.
It's an excellent play call. Excellent play call. Spread the defense out wide, get them thinking you're gonna motion out, throw it out to Tyshawn Lindsey, and let Martinez do the rest.
We've seen some impressive play from the true freshman here, back to work after missing his senior season of high school with a shoulder injury. Good decision making, and the speed of Martinez has been evident.
Yeah.
On for the extra point, Barrett Pickering. And the kick is good, and the red squad is starting to pull away. They take advantage of the Alex Davis interception and take it into the end zone behind the running of Adrian Martinez right here. Wide open in the middle, good blocking, good finish. And Martinez, all smiles right now, back on the football field and looking good early for Nebraska and Scott Frost. The Husker red squad up 28-9 as the white offense will go back to work. Damon mentioned something a moment ago about Eric Chenander, and it was one of the best quotes that I've seen from a coach anywhere, and he says, "I covet long and lean players, then let God and Zach Duvall take over." We were asking him, what do you need? What do you look for on a defense? What are you trying to recruit? He said, "I covet long and lean players, then let God and Zach Duvall take over." Pass incomplete, looking for Brandon Robbins, who was Andrew Bunch. Brings up 2nd and 10. This is a work in progress, Amir. You know that. I mean, this is not something that you turn 4-8 into 12-0 overnight. And Scott Frost knows they've got to be patient as coaches to get this thing rolling in the right direction.
Certainly. I think changing the psychology of the players is really important emphasis for Scott Frost and his coaching staff, making them believe in themselves, playing with an attitude, starting up front, and letting everybody else follow that tempo.
How do you get that confidence?
Well, start.
Just repetition.
Offense.
Repetition every day of the little things. Understanding how to disengage from blocks. Understanding how to tackle. Understanding catch, run, and finish. Those are the little things that Scott Frost, I think, is instilling with these guys this spring, and you guys are going to see more of that from the summer and the seasons coming forward.
Austin Rose. Senior from Lincoln, Nebraska, North Star High School product. Stopped at the 24-yard line. And a 3rd and 11 coming up now for the White. There's a guy who knows how to win some championships. John Cook, Nebraska volleyball coach. Yeah, he's got that national championship hat on because they're the champs, the reigning national champions. And you talk about a guy who has built a juggernaut, that Nebraska volleyball program. Even way back in Amir Abdullah's days, was right there at the top, and they're the best in the world.
He has definitely found the secret. I used to enjoy going to a lot of volleyball games during my tenure here at Nebraska. Those girls come out and they compete at a very high level every single time, and they've been a pride and joy of this university.
John Cook knows a little bit about playing before big crowds like this. They're going to be honored, get their championship rings coming up at halftime. One of the things that has happened over the years in Lincoln is they moved from the old NU Coliseum out to the Devanning Sports Center when Tom Osborne was the athletics director at Nebraska. They revamped the Devanning Sports Center, and it became volleyball's home. Much bigger crowds and an atmosphere that's been hard to beat as Honus makes the catch out to the 25-yard line.
That was encouraging seeing Lamar Jackson come up and make a big-time hit like that. He's a guy, like I spoke on earlier, who has a lot to prove, in my opinion. Being a physical force on the outside is something where I want to see him improve. Using those long arms, being more of a tackler, being a reliable corner out there.
You look at that secondary, and Damon Benning, one of the areas, as the coaches have a little fun during the spring game, one of the areas that is a concern for Nebraska, 8 scholarship defensive backs on the roster for the Huskers right now, and that's an area that they need some assistance coming in the fall.
Yeah, it was borderline alarming. You know, we heard the staff say that they normally like to carry anywhere between 15 and 16 on scholarship, and so they know that they've got some work to do that puts an unadded pressure on the development of this group currently for the young guys, but also the incoming freshmen, and not a lot to choose from. So they'll have to get it ramped up in a hurry. That's why the development of the front seven to protect a thin back end will be very, very important this summer.
So Red offense will go back to work with 45 seconds remaining in this second quarter, up 28-9. Coach Frost opting to use some timeouts to give his guys a chance to work in a little two-minute offense here, which for this offense, Amir, is almost every possession is a two-minute offense. The tempo of a two-minute drill won't throw these guys off much.
I was going to say, they've been in a two-minute offense since the beginning of this game.
Look at Will. That is the white defense here against Tristan Jebbia and the red offense. From the 33-yard line on first down, Lindsey in motion, and the swing to Lindsey. A little bit high, Lindsey trying to find some room, and he can't get away from Spencer Jordan.
Even with the negative play there, you can see Lindsey just with the ability to make people miss in the phone booth.
Reed Correll with the stop for the white squad. Jebbia, pressure coming, and a sack from Deshaun Neal. That's his second.
That's what they need. That's what they need. Third downs was a huge problem for Nebraska last year. Couldn't get off the field a lot of times. And that just comes from getting pressure internally and externally from the edge. And there's Deshaun Neal making his presence felt.
And that is the end of the first half. And it ends on a sack. And Nebraska last year, Amir, only averaged 4 tackles for loss per game. They have 11 combined so far today. Now, a green jersey helps because the touch brings you down. But still, a bit of an encouraging note if you're a Nebraska fan that there's a little bit more pressure in the backfield.
It's a marathon, not a race. To see these guys improving today is definitely going to be encouraging for these coaches.
28-9, the red leading the white at halftime. There'll be a running clock in the second half until we get to the 5-minute mark of the fourth quarter, and then they'll go back to regular clock rules if they so choose. Let's check in downstairs. Damon Benning with offensive coordinator Troy Walters.
Yeah, here with Coach Troy Walters. Coach, there's a lot to take in, and whether it's the emotion or your play, where'd you start first with in your first spring?
Well, it's exciting. Have all these fans here to support us. It's unreal. And for the guys to come out here and show the work that they've put in, it's an amazing feeling, amazing atmosphere, good start to the season, and a good finish to the spring ball.
All right, so what do you like that you've seen so far from both offensive units here?
I feel like guys are competing, going up, making plays. You know, we got to eliminate the penalties, but it looks like execution is there. We just got to go out and continue to play in the second half and make plays and have fun doing it.
All right, Coach, best wishes to you this season. Welcome.
Thank you.
All right, Damon, thanks very much. A quick timeout from Memorial Stadium in Lincoln with the red leading the white 28-9. When we return, Athletics Director Bill Moose will join me from the broadcast booth. We'll talk with the guy who brought Scott Frost back to Lincoln halftime at the spring game. Spring football on BTN is brought to you by Duluth Trading. Tough, ingenious workwear designed and tested by tradesmen. Back at Memorial Stadium, 28-9. The Red leading the White, about to get the second half underway. But first, let's check in with Damon Benning, standing by two guys who catch passes way better than Damon Benning ever did.
Yeah, both guys better receivers than Damon Benning. That would be me going third person, J.D. Spielman and Stanley Morgan. Stanley, I'm going to start with you, right? Last year, during this time, you're photobombing my interviews with Tanner Lee. This year, you're a spectator, but getting a chance to watch this offense click. This is what you work for all spring. Tell me your initial thoughts.
I'm loving the offense. I mean, you got guys catching deep balls every play. I mean, you got fast tempo. I'm loving it.
JD, you're not up to par feeling the way you want to feel, but they say you could be a key cog in this offense, especially playing this next to this guy coming off the huge freshman season. How excited are you for part two?
I mean, you know, I'm extremely excited. You know, it's going to be a big deal being able to go out there, you know, hopefully build off of, you know, what we started last year, you know. I just got to keep working, you know, keep studying my film, you know, keep picking up different parts of the game from all my teammates, you know, putting it all together, and, you know, just keep excelling.
Stanley, JD, I played with Coach Frost. I know a lot what he's about when he talks about culture and leadership. Not an old guy, JD, this year too, Stan. You are an older guy. Talk to me about leadership as it, you have to have it without this team.
It starts with Coach Frost. You know, he spreads the leadership to us, and, you know, as a leader, I spread it to the team, you know, and JD's a young guy, but he can help, you know, spread the leadership, and it goes a long way to, you know, the gel. This offense needs that. You know, we need everybody in the right place at the right time.
JD, I'll close with this. The fans know you've got to be patient. It's year one of a new offensive installation with a new staff. What do you think this offense is capable of based on what you've seen so far?
I mean, so far, I think we're capable of doing, you know, a lot of crazy things, you know. Everyone's still kind of learning, but I feel like once it clicks in everybody, you know, and once we get it rolling, I feel like, you know, I feel like we can be something extremely special.
Bella's best wishes to you. Heal up. Two of the best you'll see in the Big Ten Conference, J.D. Spielman and Stanley Morgan.
David, thanks so much. Both guys figure to factor in a large part coming up the fall. Alex Davis, who had an interception earlier, comes up with a sack here back in the 25. Noah Vedral really has this White offense clicking though prior to that sack, Amir.
Yeah, that Red defense needed that sack. How fast they were going, man. The half just starting already in the red zone, green zone.
After the sack, Vedral to work again to the sideline, and Honus with a drop at the 20-yard line. Will Honus has been very involved, though, in this offense. Transfer out of Butler Community, Todd Honus, the sophomore out of Aurora, Nebraska. Third and 15 at the 25. Good protection down the sideline, looking for Reimers, and Reimers can't pull it in. Out of bounds, incomplete.
Something that these coaches said they wanted to see more from these defensive backs are making plays on the ball. You know, this is the ball right here where you got to get your head, you got to get turned around a little bit quicker to make a better play on this ball. I'm not sure if that wasn't completed.
Well, they looked at the big screen to make a touchdown ruling earlier, but the word is that the 2-yard line is where he stepped out. And they're going to try a long field goal instead. This will be Cole Fromm from 43. And Fromm's kick off the upright and no good. So Cole Fromm hits the right upright, and the White comes away empty on their opening possession. Scott Frost did not exactly, Amir, get handed an easy schedule to start off his tenure at Nebraska. Akron coming to town to start things off. Terry Bowden, the head coach of the Zips, then Colorado and Troy. And then Big Ten play starts at the Big House before Purdue comes calling. They're at Wisconsin to start October, always a date that Husker fans circle on the calendar. Then at Northwestern, home for Minnesota. Then you start November in Columbus before Illinois and Michigan State are in town, and you close the season at Iowa. That is a really tough slate I don't care who you are, Mikhail Wilbon out to the 28-yard line. But when you're a first-year coach trying to take a 4-8 program and start to turn it around, that's not exactly the schedule you wanted to draw.
No, it's not. But I know he's up to challenges. He's a very competitive individual, so he's not going to expect his team to wither at all.
George Darlington on hand, former Nebraska defensive backs coach, checking things out. Wilbon trying to get to the edge. A little nudge from Breon Dixon to the sideline at the 33. Well, that's a guy that Nebraska would certainly love to see out there come the fall. Breon Dixon, the transfer from Ole Miss, still waiting on word from the NCAA as far as his waiver goes. Played in 6 games as a true freshman for Ole Miss last year. Could play safety, could play linebacker. Run him at linebacker most of the day today. Martinez to the air, a little tall for Austin Allen, and you've got to be tall to get it over the head of Austin Allen, who stands at 6'8".
Yeah, that may be the first ill-advised or errant throw I've seen Martinez make today.
He has been on for most of the day, but the punt team on now, and Caleb Lightmore to punt it away. First punt from the Husker returner at punter. Lightmore finished 6th in the conference a year ago in punting, averaging just over 42 yards per punt.
Not sure if Nebraska special teams have a returner back there.
They do not. So Lightbourne's going to get a nice average on this punt as it goes out of bounds at the 14-yard line. Caleb Lightmore says thank you very much. The one punt goes out of bounds at the 14-yard line. And so pinned deep that white offense. 54-yard punt for Lightmore. They're going to move it out to the 25 because it's a spring game and you can't.
Yeah, you know.
And Andrew Bunch back to work helming the white offense.
I tell you what, if this is vanilla for these coaches today, I'm really excited to see what they're going to bring come season time, because they're motioning running backs into the backfield, going empty sets.
Batted down. Good pressure coming from Matt Jarzynka. Senior out of Loup City, Nebraska. So Jarzynka getting himself an opportunity in the spring game. He's yet to see action in a game as a Husker. Came in 2014 and redshirted. A big moment for him out here in the spring game before this giant crowd. Bunch batted down again at the line. Ben Stilley got his hand up on that one. Now this crowd thinned out a little bit as the game's gone on, but 86,800 plus at kickoff today. One of the top 10 crowds in college football history for a spring game.
My freshman year, that was the max. That's what the stadium used to hold until they made the renovations and added the upper deck, but that is definitely impressive to see today.
On 3rd down and 10. Bunch guns it over the middle, juggled it incomplete. He had Christian Banker there, and the freshman found an opening. Bunch put it there, just couldn't pull it in.
I definitely like the confidence of Bunch. He feels like he can fit into any window. I saw him make a couple of throws earlier I kind of was cringing at, but he gets it there.
Has to punt this one away, though, does Isaac Armstrong after that red defense comes up with a stop. Avery Roberts there. A guy who could factor into the mix here at that inside linebacker spot. They'd ideally like 4 to 6 guys in the middle of that 4 linebacker group back there that'll rotate through as the fair catch is called for and made by Mike Williams. And the red offense back to work once more. Looks like this will be a Tristan Jebbia series. They're not going to name a starter, Amir, at the end of this spring practice. Each quarterback has done some good things today, though, and certainly has staked their claim to that starting job come the fall.
Well, they definitely have their work cut out for them. I'm sure they're going to go back and evaluate all the tape from spring, not just today, to make a clear-cut decision on it. But these quarterbacks aren't making it easy.
Motion from Greg Bell. Low snap. Jebbia going to work, and Butler trying to touch him up on the outside. Got a hand on him. We've seen a few low snaps from the red squad today. Should point out again that you're looking at no Cole Conrad, you're looking at no Michael Decker. There's going to be different guys snapping the football once the fall begins. Hunter Miller, the redshirt freshman walk-on out of Stromsburg, Nebraska, handling that center position for the Red today.
Yeah, now the offensive line is one of the more veteran groups here for this club, so that's not necessarily a point of issue for this team.
Jebbia under pressure, and he's sacked. Finn Anderson got in there for the sack. And Damon Benning, we talk about that offensive line and those snaps, certainly not a huge concern for the coaches right now because they know there'll be other guys in there. But Scott Frost, talking with us yesterday, liked what he has seen out of Matt Farniok at right tackle and Brendan Hymus at left tackle as far as the size and skill for guys that they're looking for in an offensive line.
Yeah, right. That's a big body type staff, right? And they really said, and he was very matter of fact, he said those two would be exactly what we were looking for regardless of where we were recruiting in terms of body type. And then we got the familiar follow-up, right? The dot, dot, dot. But this is going to be an important summer with Zach Duvall and company.
I think that's going to kind of be the reoccurring theme. That was the one position group outside of maybe the surprise at quarterback where he kind of sat up in his seat because I think he likes the potential up front. You guys know that he's a big fan of what Greg Austin is capable of doing.
Yeah, former Husker Greg Austin is the offensive line coach. And you know, they've talked about it throughout the spring and when they came from UCF, that this system, Amir, does a lot of favors for offensive linemen. The tempo that they play at can wear down a defense, and that offensive line, as the game goes on, can find it maybe a little easier to work against that guy on the other
Most
side.
Most definitely. Anytime the guy is huffing and puffing across from you, it makes it a lot easier for you to get on a double team to the linebacker to the next level. I expect this running game to really improve with this high-tempo offense.
And Damon, we talked about guys that are going to factor into that offensive line mix. If the season were starting today,
okay,
Hymus,
okay,
Foster, Farmer, Farniok, are those the guys, Damon, that you'd see on that offensive line? If the season were starting today, is it Hymus and Farniok at the tackles and Foster and Farmer at the guards?
I think ideally, Kevin, that's where those guys would really like to book in, and they're starting to embrace it, right? Hymus is one of the rare guys that says, hey, even though he started as a right tackle, as a pup, he says, I'm more comfortable on the left side. And that's a big-time position, as folks that love football know. So that's a good place to start because you not only get some youth, but you get a little bit of want-to, too.
With a good run from the junior college transfer, Greg Bell. His junior college teammates nicknamed him the Eel, which is an outstanding nickname. And the Eel gets another carry here. And he runs into the arms of freshman Andrew Ward, redshirt freshman out of the state of Michigan.
Been really impressed with these defenses swarming to the ball. On every tackle, it seems to be more than one hat. And that's definitely a winning equation anytime you can do that.
On second down, Wyatt Mazur with the carry, and Mazur down to the 43-yard line. One area we've not talked a lot about is that kicking area, and while it probably doesn't get a lot of attention, it has been a battle this year between the scholarship kicker Barrett Pickering and the redshirt freshman Cole Fromm, who walked on from Omaha Burke, is Wyatt Mazur into the clear, and Mazur is going to take it for the touchdown. 43 yards for Wyatt Mazur.
Excellent read. He did something I like to do, is play an in-and-out game with the linebackers, make you think you're going one way. At the last minute, jump cut, get around, and there was no one else there.
One more look, and untouched. Wyatt Mazur into the end zone for six. He had a big spring game last year, 57 yards on the ground in the spring game a year ago, 52 yards rushing in the spring game today. He is the leading rusher for both squads again. And the extra point is good for Pickering.
It's always special to see Nebraska kids come out in the spring game. Who a lot of these kids are walk-ons. A lot of the support comes from in-state, obviously, of this club. Come on, have games like he's had these last couple 2 years.
Well, he was a terrific quarterback at Boone Central High School in Nebraska, first-team Superstater. And showing that those skills translate from the quarterback position in high school to the running back spot in the spring game. And Wyatt Mazur getting some love from Tristan Chebbia. Always good to see those guys get their opportunities.
Noah Vedral leading this drive.
Federal probably the odd man out this year, barring some sort of Hail Mary waiver that he has thrown. But probably the Bishop Newman product from Wahoo, Nebraska, is going to have to watch this season from the sidelines and help out his teammates. There's a little running room there for Austin Rose, gets the first down to the 48-yard line.
There's another one of those Nebraska homegrown kids who stuck through this program, worked extremely hard. It's nice to see him get some carries today. Excellent patience on that run.
Saw a little bit of action in a reserve role last year. Had a kickoff return, a short kickoff return, 13 yards a year ago. And a tough catch in traffic, but a loss on the play for Todd Honus. Back it up to the 46-yard line.
I think that was Antonio Reed. That's a guy who I think is going to play a big factor on this defense. A big physical presence. Coming up and just disposing that block right there to blow that bubble screen up.
And he's a guy who really has to play a big role this year. We talked about the scholarship numbers in the secondary. Reed, one of those starters who comes in, and there's a sack for Alex Davis, who's had a fine day for this Red squad. We've called his name a lot.
Well, I'm done now, but it's still tight.
Junior out of Florida who has been in the backfield, has an interception. But you look at that secondary with eight scholarship defensive backs. Antonio Reed's a guy who's going to have to play a really large role in that safety spot.
Yeah, and he's very versatile. I mean, you can move him into the box. He maybe can play a little nickel as well. But safety is definitely his natural position.
Third and 18 from the 40 for Vedral. Pressure again. Vedral looked like he was sacked. They didn't whistle him down. And Damian Jackson didn't get the sack that he was hoping to get on that play. Looked like he touched him up. And Damian Jackson is one of the best stories in college football. Adam Kramer wrote a terrific article online this week about the former Navy SEAL. 25 years old, he'll be 26 before the season starts. A freshman who didn't play football in high school, played baseball and soccer, then served his country as a Navy SEAL. Came back, decided he wanted to try football, and has been working a little bit, not only as a lineman this year, but as a long snapper, trying to figure out ways to get on the field.
Definitely a tough individual. I was speaking to the coaches, and he's been battling through some sickness the last couple weeks. So to see him out here playing today just is a testament to how tough this guy is.
Yeah, he had that virus that this team has been plagued over the last week to 10 days with a virus that's kind of run through the team. There have been a lot of guys who haven't been up to par. Stanley Morgan, one of those guys, a little under the weather. Damian Jackson was one of those guys, too, and we were told yesterday we weren't going to see him today.
Yeah.
But he's a Navy SEAL, and I guess he had different ideas.
I'm sure he's been through a couple worse situations, I'm sure.
Spent time in Yemen and in Southeast Asia as a Navy SEAL, and Scott Frost told us yesterday, he said, I don't know what he's going to be doing on the team, but he's going to be playing a big role in this locker room and on this team.
Definitely.
Here's Martinez on the keep, and as close as we've seen to a quarterback getting tackled today when he ran up that sideline.
I really like the dynamic that Martinez brings. You know, he has so much speed that it's really forcing the defense to be honest anytime he goes into a running back quarterback exchange.
Run for a little bit of yardage from Mikhail Wilbon. Up to the 21-yard line. Scott Frost. A lot of Scott Frost t-shirts. If you're a t-shirt maker and you haven't capitalized on Scott Frost coming back, you've missed an opportunity. There are plenty of them around the state of Nebraska. A native son coming home to try to bring this program back to national prominence after a few really rugged years. Martinez on the move, and Adrian Martinez showing the wheels again. Every time he runs, I look over at Amir, and Amir's got a little grin on his face like, this kid's showing something.
Anytime a quarterback can take the pressure off of running back as far as bringing a running threat, it makes the offense so much more dynamic. So I know Scott Frost is going to enjoy his time with this guy.
Final play of this third quarter as Austin Allen with the catch. And Allen making some guys miss. And Austin Allen, another tight end weapon for the Huskers down to the white 45. At the end of the third quarter, it's all red. When we return, Damon Benning with the head coach, Scott Frost. While you were away, one punt catch for a student for $25,000. And that reaction tells the story. Watch this. He fields it cleanly. $25,000. And the team comes out to swarm him. What a moment for that young man. Not only does he get swarmed at the spring game, but that punt catch gives him $25,000. That's a good Saturday at Memorial Stadium, Amir Abdullah.
That's an excellent Saturday. I should have been down there catching that ball.
I believe you are not eligible anymore. And now he's getting the ball signed by Husker greats. Football.
Just gets better and better.
What a day. 25 grand, a signed football, mobbed by the Husker squad. Mike Rozier's only going to charge him $24,500 for that autograph.
That's awesome.
One more look at a pretty big moment. $25,000. Amir, how'd he do?
You know, he got up under it nicely. Make sure he shielded it with his chest. I'll give it an 8.5. 8.5.
I give it a 25K.
Yeah, my 8.5 is nothing to us at 25K. So my opinion doesn't really matter too much.
And now the media mobbing him. Congratulations. We go back to work here for the Red Squad. Adrian Martinez, the quarterback, and Martinez on the keep, and Martinez touched up at the 41 by Jacob Weinmaster. All red today, 35-9 in this Nebraska spring game.
Martinez might be one of the leading rushers today and can't even get tackled, so that says a lot.
He's done the job today and has given Husker fans plenty of fodder over the next several weeks, I'm sure. Bell down to the 35, should have the first down. I would assume that a few sports talk shows in the state of Nebraska will find conversation around the play of Adrian Martinez and the rest of these quarterbacks to keep them company over the next few months.
Certainly. It's been a lot of competition this spring. And just to see these guys come out and perform like this, I know it's going to be the talk of the town and carry on into the season.
Martinez with pressure again up the middle from Weinmaster, and Weinmaster with the sack. As we go downstairs, David Bennings with the head man.
All right, Coach, a rapidly moving day. Let's start on the offensive side of the ball. What have you seen that you can be encouraged by, and where do you want to go to work?
I see good things. There's some sloppy things out here, too, but this is the first few steps and a long journey for us. I think we're doing some really good things. We've got a long way to go. We're staying vanilla, making some mistakes. We're making good plays, too.
For those of us kind of watching at home, what did you expect to see that's kind of come to fruition, whether it's to the positive or negative, like maybe formations or procedure, even tempo?
You know, I think the tempo's been decent. We still got to push it a little more, but I want our guys to have the ability to play fast when we need to. I'm seeing guys making some plays on both sides of the ball, and I think the details and the rest of it will come along later.
Let's go to the defensive side of the ball. You like the effort and kind of energy. I know you've been a big proponent of better tackling and playing with toughness and confidence. How do you feel there?
Like we're part of the way there. I'm starting to see it. I just want to see more grit. I want to see guys grinding, physical, playing tough with toughness, and we're starting to see it. We got some ways to go yet.
All right, Coach, appreciate your time.
While Scott Frost was talking, his hand-picked true freshman quarterback made maybe the best run he's had of the day in a day filled with some good runs. Amir Abdullah just looked at me during that run with his eyes wide. What'd you see here, Amir?
Oh, man, the minute he pulled that ball, I knew that defender was in trouble. He had him in space, gave him a little hesitation. Then he accelerates here. I like the guttiness, too, to dive for that thing, man. He's showing a lot today.
We should mention that the longest run by a Nebraska quarterback last year was 14 yards by Patrick O'Brien. Martinez has runs of 15 and 23 today. I know it's a spring game, but that's just an indication of times they are changing at Nebraska, and the offense of last year is not the offense of this year.
It certainly isn't. To see these quarterbacks, especially Martinez today, come and instrument these drives the way they have in the spread attack, it's definitely going to be encouraging. These guys are going to feed around that energy to have quarterbacks like this who can lead a team as well.
And on first down, Divine Ozigbo reversing his field. And Ozigbo gets back to the line of scrimmage. Actually loses about 2.5 yards. Didn't get back to that line of scrimmage. At the 22-yard line, we go back to Damon Benning.
Two guys that could be heavily counted on once fall practice starts, Mick Stoltenberg and Luke Gifford. Mick, I'll start with you. As a spectator, you got a chance to get a taste of spring and what this defense wants to accomplish. First of all, how's your progress? And second of all, where do you feel you're capable of going defensively?
I'm feeling great right now. You know, come our May workouts this summer, I'll be 100% and ready to go and ready to kind of get going there physically. But, you know, one thing I'm seeing that we're trying to improve on the defense is, you know, we're going against a pretty high-tempo offense in practice every day. Just communicating, simply getting lined up. You know, obviously intensity after the snap. Specifically for the D-line we're working on, you know, making sure we're continuing to knock guys back, kind of get penetration, get some knockback on offensive linemen, and kind of fill our gaps from there and make some plays. So it's been a good spring, and we're starting to get a grasp for the new defense. And obviously it's great working against an offense that moves that fast for sure.
You've prided yourself on your fitness, obviously, and being in shape. There's your level of fitness and where you want to be. Then there's Coach Frost's level of fitness and where you need to be. What's the difference so far?
You know, it just comes with the way we practice. You know, we start off practice with a pretty dynamic warm-up. I look at the blood flowing, and, you know, we've got tempo periods sprinkled in everywhere, and there's really no downtime during practice, you know. Not a lot of buffer time in between periods. You know, you're kind of always moving. So if you're not in shape, then you're not practicing the correct way. The practice sets you up to be in the right shape for sure.
All right, Luke, a guy that our fans are anxious to see back out there, coming off a successful last year. You're ready to build. How are you feeling?
No, I feel great. I'm getting there. I'm hoping to be ready to roll by summer workouts. So I'm on the right track, and I'm anxious to get back out there for sure.
One of the things I noticed right away, because I see you quite a bit bigger than you were a year ago at this time. The weight room has treated you well.
Yeah, it's been good, but surgery time was rough. You know, just I had never put on weight like that. And so sitting out and not being able to do anything for two or three months, it was tough. I put on a lot of weight. I'm actually around 245 right now, which is the most I've ever weighed, you know. So I'm getting down to what I want to be, and I feel pretty good.
I see you walking around. You got quite a smile. Is that due to there's this family environment, and then there's the fact I think you like what this defense is capable of?
Yeah, you know, I see glimpses of it every day in practice. You know, I'm excited to play in it. And then, you know, as a kid from Nebraska, being able to play for Coach Frost and seeing the way things are changing and like you said, the family atmosphere, it's really cool.
Now, one to watch. Our fans are happy to hear from you and know that you're doing well. One of the stalwarts from a year ago, that's Luke Gifford.
Yeah, he's been out with that hip injury. And Eric Chenander telling us yesterday, Amir, I'm anxious to see him. I've not really had a chance to see him. And he said, look, I didn't watch much of last year. Watched a couple of games. He said it wasn't really teaching me anything. So I didn't really watch a lot of the tape last year. So when he sees Luke Gifford on the field, that's really going to be his first chance to see what Luke Gifford can do.
Yeah, and Luke really brings a leadership quality that this defense is going to need. There's going to be a lot of young players filling in on this defense. So to have someone like Luke back and as well as Mick Stoltenberg, it's going to be key for him. I've seen Luke grow from a safety to a linebacker, and he looked almost as big as Mick standing there. So I'm excited to see him become, you know, even better in this new defense.
Bo Cottrell with the carry there for Nebraska. Gets another carry here. Trying to get to the edge. And not much room out there, but he fights his way through a tackle from Breon Dixon and dragging Dixon all the way out to the 38-yard line.
Nice strong run there.
Trill at the end here. That's Dixon on his back, and he just barrels forward. Avery Anderson trying to bring him down, not having much success either. Jebbia, and the catch made by Justin McGriff to the 43.
Jebbia has a very quick release, very quick release. You see a lot of these spot route concepts going to run today. I think he has a good mind for timing, understanding when the eyes of the receiver is going to lock with his to, you know, get that ball out quick.
Catch on the edge. A little bit of running room. And even more running room. Going down the sidelines and not stopping. It's a touchdown. Cade Warner into the end zone for six.
That's not going to make the defensive coaches happy. Good play by Cade Warner for sure, making the guy miss there. But tackling, like we said before, has been a big issue for this defense in years prior. And it's definitely not going to make the coaches happy right there.
Cade Warner redshirted a year ago, was a preferred walk-on for the Huskers in fall of 2017. He broke the state of Arizona record, had 241 catches in his high school career at Desert Mountain High School in Scottsdale. Of course, comes from awfully good bloodlines. His dad, Kurt, you know, Hall of Famer.
Not I've bad. Heard of him once or twice.
But Cade Warner able to get onto the field. He switched teams. He was on the white roster for most of the day, now on the red side. And does that mean he gets to be on the winner's parade at the end of the game? He was on the white side most of the time, and now has switched to the red, up 49-9.
Well, either way, I know he's enjoying that touchdown now.
No question about that. So for Cade Warner, his first taste of the end zone as a Husker. In a very deep wide receiver room. Vedrill back out at quarterback for the white team. Originally, the clock was going to go back to normal rules once we got under 5 minutes. That is not going to be the case now. They're just going to let the clock continue to be a running clock through the rest of this fourth quarter. With the red well in control of this game at 49-9. Scott Frost has seen a lot from his teams. And the fumble gives it back to the red. Antonio Reed recovering that fumble, and it'll be the red ball once more with Adrian Martinez back to work.
And that's something this team has got to create a lot more this year, turnovers. You know, too many times the defense is on the field too long, bearing those long drives. You got to have more playmakers step up, take that ball away.
Not much room for Ben Miles on his first carry. Back at the 32-yard line, it'll be second and 10.
I'm impressed with Deshaun Neal today. He was the lead tackler on that game tackle right there. He's a guy who's definitely grown into his body. He came in kind of lanky. He's a big kid now. He can play inside. He can play outside. I know he's going to be a big factor on that star, you know, touted defensive line they have right now.
Second down, Miles again with the carry. Runs right into the arms of Deshaun Neal once more, who was in the midst of being blocked, Amir, and was still able to make the tackle.
Yeah, that's what you need. You need a guy to be able to reach those long arms out. He's about 6'7", 6'8", I would say. So he definitely has the frame. He needs to just be there every single game, show up for him.
Amir, they've only got him listed for two tackles.
Two sacks.
I mean, Deshaun Neal's about three more tackles away from being shirtless. Martinez, fake, little dodge, and the tackle made by Damian Daniels on the touch. But Martinez's elusiveness is going to have people dreaming about where he's going to go as his career moves on after they've watched this spring game.
Definitely. I know expectations are definitely going to be managed after today by, you know, Scott Frost, because he's done a lot of great things today. But to watch his growth in his offense is going to be interesting, and I'm hoping the best for him.
Swing pass to Cottrell. And Cottrell taking on the tacklers at Avery Anderson. He rolled over Anderson.
I'm sure Avery Anderson's going to be targeting a little bit lower next time.
Anderson immediately went to the bench and is being looked at. Where Cottrell's helmet hit him was on that left arm. There you see Avery Anderson being tended to as Martinez to the outside looking for a block, and he got that block from Justin McGriff.
Yeah. I know Stanley Morgan is an outstanding blocker as a receiver. So I know a lot of these young receivers watch him, the tempo he sets, and knowing that it's important, you know, for this running game to be efficient and productive. You need those guys on the outside, especially with as much as swing passes they do, hitting people on the flats. These guys got to be warriors out there blocking.
We talked about it earlier, Troy Walters keeping a chart of those blocking points in the wide receiver room. That'll be a point there for Justin McGriff.
And he gets rewarded here.
That's right, he gets rewarded with a pass catch. He lost his helmet in the process down to the 11-yard line. Justin McGriff.
He seems to be okay walking off the field there. May not have been a reward he necessarily wanted.
Deshaun Neal again coming up to provide the hit at the end of that. Almost had a handle on that football as well. And he did recover it. So that will be a turnover, and Deshaun Neal recovers the loose ball. And the white offense will get one more crack with 3:32 to go in the fourth. Austin Hemphill, walk on out of Gretna High School in Nebraska. Hemphill, 5'10", 225-pound junior, was a state champion power lifter in his high school days.
That is not foreign to the Gretna alumni. Andy Genovich was a Gretna kid himself who was a workout warrior, so I'm sure he's learned from here.
Andy Genovich now with the Denver Broncos. Remember last year the comment was from the coaching staff in Denver, if we had 11 Andy Janoviches, we'd be a much better team.
Oh, man, that guy is one of the hardest workers you will ever meet, and it's just a testament to the Nebraska style. You know, a lot of these kids in this state work extremely hard, and to see these kids out here now performing, it's just a testament how hard they work.
Well, Mears, we're winding down this spring game. A, it's been fun working with you, but B, when you leave here today, what's your impression going to be of Nebraska football heading into the 2018 season?
You know, looking at the 4-8 season they had last year, I wasn't very encouraged coming in today. But what I've seen is a lot better managed team. As you can see, offensively, they're signaling things fast, getting things into these players fast, and these kids are executing. And I really think this team is going to be at its best when they're playing fast. You know, defensively and offensively. And as smooth as these quarterbacks have, like I said before, instrumented these drives, is encouraging because it starts with them. So I saw a pretty complete game. Tackling is still something I want them to improve on, and I'm sure they will.
Fourth down and four, Noah Vedral and the offense staying out there for the white team. Vedral in some trouble, heads for the sideline and incomplete. And even if Brandon Robbins had been able to pull that in, pretty sure he was out of bounds before the ball got to him, so would have been an ineligible receiver. Instead, it's a turnover on downs. And the Red offense, with a minute 37 to go in the fourth, will run this one out and end the 2018 spring game. Ball to the 17-yard line.
Tristan Jebbia in there. Finish this thing out.
Ben Miles sharing a word before this one comes to a close. There's Miles. Miles works his way down to the 12-yard line. It's interesting to see for guys like Ben Miles what the future holds. There is no fullback anymore at the University of Nebraska. Ben Miles, of course, one of the better fullbacks in the country in his senior year in high school at Baton Rouge Catholic High School. And his dad, of course, former head coach at LSU and Oklahoma State. Now a guy who spent some time with the booth, With Fox?
Yeah. Well, Scott Frost, speaking to him yesterday, he has a very creative mind. So I'm sure guys who bring the physicality like what Ben does, he's going to have a place on this team, whether it's at maybe slot tight end or maybe moving to the other side of the ball, and, of course, special teams.
Well, Scott Frost will put the wraps on this one for his first spring game as head coach. Of course, when he came back from Stanford in 1995, his first spring game, he was ineligible to play that year as he had to sit out, but he was able to get out there, throw three touchdown passes in that 1995 spring game, and springboarded him on to a two-year starting role, and of course leading the Huskers to the national title in 1997. Barrett Pickering on, trying a 27-yard field goal. And Pickering's kick is no good. Missed that one wide to the right.
Looks like they had a little trouble with the snap there. The kicking game hasn't been as clean as they probably would like, and anytime you lose a kicker like Drew Brown last year, that's always a heavy replacement to bear.
I want to remind you that coming up when we're done here, the Big Ten Spring Football Report, and a chance to hear Jerry DiNardo's sit-down conversation with Nebraska head coach Scott Frost. Good conversation that they had a few days ago. You're going to want to hear that if you're a Nebraska fan, or even if you're a fan of college football. That's coming up, the Big Ten Spring Football Report, later on today. The blue-white game from Happy Valley as Penn State gets on the field. About a team that will go into a season with some expectations. Saquon Barkley not there, but a lot of talent back for Penn State. And that is the end of the first spring game in the new regime at Nebraska under head coach Scott Frost. Adrian Martinez, one of the stars of this 2018 spring game. Plenty of talk will center around that young man, Amir, over the next few weeks and months.
All smiles from Adrian Martinez, and I'm pretty sure it's all smiles from Scott Frost as it was his first successful spring game. And looking forward to this team growing with each and every month and until season time.
Well, a fun afternoon in Lincoln, Nebraska. Scott Frost all smiles right now. Giving a big hug to Stanley Morgan and J.D. Spielman as this one comes to a close.